Question one. How have you subverted or conformed to genre conventions within your production? In our short film, we have conformed to many... An example of this would be that we have chosen to film in an isolated place, like they are short films made by students like me. As you can see, they're both filmed in isolated locations, making it more scary for the audience because there's no way out. Here you can see we have done the same within our short film because it's filmed in an isolated location, therefore we have conformed to the common conventions within our genre of horror.
After boys.
My mom says the same exact thing. Who knows? Maybe they're right.
You know, instead of changing in my house, why don't we just change in the woods?
Is it safe?
Yeah, my sister and her friends used to smoke pot there all the time.
In this clip of the short film Stay Out of the Woods, you can see there is two innocent-looking protagonists. Now, this is really common within the genre of horror, to have really innocent sort of protagonists, victims, making it... So, because it makes it easier to sympathise for them and feel sorry for them. We've done this within our short film because we've used a young girl, which is our innocent protagonist, but we've also emphasised this by our use of props as she's got a teddy bear in her hand, which makes her look even more innocent in a way.
He's coming soon, isn't he?
We also haven't used any superficial light within our short film, meaning that the audience very much feels like they're in the position of the character because we've used lots of point of view shots as well. So the point of view shots and the use of no superficial lighting means that it looks so realistic, so the audience is more likely to connect with the scene and to feel scared. This is enhanced by the use of handheld camera work, making it seem like you're really there. also conform to other common genre conventions, such as using depth within the shot, so you can't see exactly what's going on, so it creates more fear for the audience, like they can't see exactly what's going on. Generally, we have decided to advertise our short film as a horror. However, since we've done extended research into genre theories and conventions of genre, we've decided that it is up to interpretation, that I think our short film is a psychological thriller. This can be connected with Bordwell's theory of Markov genres, meaning that no necessary and sufficient conditions can mark off genres. Basically, there's no set genre. Like, we've got things. I think mine is a psychological horror because it's got a twist in it and it's got slightly crude in a way, and can also be connected with Stam's theory. He says, are genres really out there in the world, or are they merely the constructions of analysts? This is basically saying that genres are different, are completely different to everyone. Because I've now done more research into genre theories, I now believe that the genre is a different thing to, but our short film is a horror, just based on, this can be based on our ancillary tasks as well, as I have made my poster look really dark, and it's set, and there's a background of the woods, so there's the isolation in there. And my magazine review is also really dark, and you can see pictures of the woods and the man and the bear, so it makes it seem like, from a first glance, you'd think it was horror just purely because of my ancillary tasks and the general storyline of the short film. For example, our target audience, which are students, teachers, people, other members who go to short film festivals, examiners, filmmakers, they might have a different interpretation of our genre from our short film because of their extended knowledge of forms of conventions and genre. So basically, because like me, they have studied into great detail about genre and conventions within genres, they might also have different interpretations of it purely because of their extended knowledge. So the definition of psychological horror is an element of horror that toys with the mind and targets the psychological. Generally, this horror is internal and deals with the inner darkness of human thought. Our short film does reflect that statement, that definition, because there is a twist in it, and it is quite dark and twisted, and the fact that the man stabs the teddy bear, it sort of leaves it into our own mind what actually happens. So that was what I would say, it plays on the mind, toys with the mind, that's how it relates.